안녕하십니까?
Hello, everyone.
예. 오늘 날씨가 아주 좋습니다.
Today the weather is very nice.
아까 추워서 그렇지.
It's a little bit cold.
여기 추운지 모르고 이렇게 왔는데.
I didn't know it's going to be very cold here.
그래서 여기서 이렇게 CLF 옷을 하나씩 나눠주더라고요.
So here I came and they gave all of us a CLF jacket.
아, 그것도 누가 볼 때 추워하는 것 같아서 그런지.
So maybe they think that we might be cold.
아, 오늘 아침 새벽에 누가 나한테 찾아왔더라고요.
And this morning someone came up to me.
목사님 추워 보이시는데.
Pastor, you look a little cold.
오리털 잠바를 사가지고 왔습니다.
You know, I bought you this down jacket.
그래서 아디다스에서 나오는 잠바를 사가지고 왔어요.
It's an Adidas jacket.
너무 감사한 거예요.
I was so thankful.
하나님은 우리의 모든 것을 알고 계시는데.
So God knows everything about us.
하나님께서 이렇게 하나님 앞에 살 때마다.
So every time we live in front of God.
내가 나를 위해서 준비하는 것보다.
And rather than me preparing for myself.
하나님이 나를 위해 준비하시는 것들이 너무 많습니다.
But there's so many more that God has prepared for me.
우리 찬송가에 보면.
If you look at the hymnal.
내 모든 형편 다 아시는 주님.
There's a lyric that says, God who knows all my circumstances.
늘 돌보아 주실 것을 나는 확실히 아네.
And I trust in the Lord who will always watch over me.
찬송가 410장이 나오는데.
This hymnal is a 412.
하나님의 은혜로 있을 데 없는 자.
So without God's grace, we cannot survive.
왜 구속하여 주는지 난 알 수 없도다.
I don't know why God has saved me.
내가 믿고 또 의지함은
The one that I believe and depend on.
내 모든 형편 다 아시는 주님.
The Lord who knows about all my circumstances.
늘 돌보아 주실 것을 난 확실히 믿네.
I believe in the Lord who will truly look after me all times.
여러분들도 그 찬송을 기억하십니까?
Do you know about this hymnal?
가장 은혜로운 구절이 내 모든 형편 다 아시는 주.
So the most gracious lyric is the Lord who knows about all my circumstances.
그래서 하나님은 우리에게 장갑이 필요하다고 하나님 앞에 구하면
So if we seek after God that we need a glove
손가락 다섯 개인 장갑을 주더라고요.
So God always gives us a glove that fits my five fingers, right?
왜냐면 우리 손가락이 다섯 개인 줄 알기 때문에.
Because God knows that we have five fingers on our hands.
신발을 주세요 하고 기도하면.
And when we pray before God, God, I need shoes.
구두 하나 주는 게 아니고.
He doesn't just give us one pair.
한
pair.
두 개를 주십니다.
He always gives us a pair, two.
그래서 우리가 무엇을 필요하는지.
So God knows what we need.
또 무엇을 원하는지.
What we want.
다 아시는 거예요.
So God knows everything about this.
시편 20편 4절에 보면.
If you look at Psalms 20 verse 4.
마음의 소원을 주시고.
So God He hears our desires.
마음의 소원대로 허락하시고.
And He allows everything according to our heart.
내 모든 도모를 이루시기를 원하노라 그랬어.
And so He's the God who will help us.
그래서 하나님은 우리에게 모든 것을 다 주시고
So God gives us everything.
필요한 것을 아셔서 주시는 분입니다.
And he's the one who knows what we need and gives it to us.
자, 오늘 너무 시간이 짧아 가지고
So we have a short time today.
다 진행하는데 좀 시간이 많이 부족하지만
So we're going to try to go through this but we might lack a little bit of time.
자, 우리가 이제 어제 이야기를 했습니다.
So we talked about this yesterday.
복을 받기 위해서는
In order for you to be blessed,
세 가지 조건이 필요하다 그랬습니다.
There's two conditions to be met.
하나는 발견하는 것이고
One is that you need to discover.
이 발견이 되면 변화가 일어납니다.
And through this discovery you'll be able to change.
이 변화된 사람들은 연결된 삶을 통해서
And those who change will be connected to others.
하나님께서 모든 것을 주시는 하나님을 경험하게 됩니다.
And that you'll receive and experience God who has prepared everything for you.
그래서 어제 잠깐 복습한다면
So if we review from yesterday
우리가 가장 갇혀 살고 가장 어두웠을 때 언제냐면
So when is the time that we're the hardest and we're trapped?
사람들이 생각 안에 갇혀 있을 때였습니다.
It is when people are trapped in their own thoughts.
사람들은 지구가 네모지다고 믿었습니다.
So they believe that the world was flat.
눈으로 보고 우리의 생각으로 느끼는 그 세계를 살아왔습니다.
So they only believed in what they saw and what they felt.
그래서 사람들은 멀리 나가는데 자유가 없었습니다.
And so when people travel far they didn't have much freedom.
멀리 나가면 가면 이렇게 낭떠러지가 있어 떨어질 거라고 생각했습니다.
Because if they travel far, they'll come to a cliff and then they'll fall.
그래서 그 눈으로 보는 세계, 느끼는 세계를 벗어나지 못한 거예요.
So people cannot escape from the world of what they see.
그래서 사람들이 지식이 발달되고,
so as people's knowledge advance,
지혜가 형성되고,
and the more like education,
그래서 과학의 지식들이 들어오면서,
and then we learn more about the, you know, scientific discoveries.
하나의 변화가 일어납니다.
And so we had a change, right?
어떤 변화가 있냐면
What change was that?
우리가 보고 있는 것이 틀렸구나.
What we see is wrong.
지구는 둥글구나.
The earth is not flat, it is round.
이 가장 중요한 변화는
So the most important change
내가 보고 느끼는 이것이 틀렸구나.
The fact that what I see, what I feel is actually wrong.
이게 가장 큰 변화입니다.
So that is the greatest change.
내 생각이 틀렸구나.
My thoughts are wrong.
내 생각이 틀렸고
My thoughts are wrong.
말씀의 세계로 옮겨지면서
And when you move over to the world of the word of God
우리는 새로운 변화를 얻습니다.
They will experience a new change.
우리가 한번 생각을 한번 해 보겠습니다.
Let us think about this.
어떤 사람이 어떤 여자가 남편과 결혼을 했습니다.
Let's say a woman married this man.
사람들은 다 확인을 해보고 싶은 마음이 있는 거예요.
And so everyone wants to find out, you know, make sure before they get married.
그 여자가 right? 살다가 이렇게 남편에게 물어봤습니다.
And so as she lived with this man, she asked the man.
자기야, 나 사랑해.
Hey, do you really love me?
Yes, 사랑한다 그랬어요.
And he said, yes, I love you.
얼마만큼?
How much?
하늘만큼, 땅만큼.
As big as the heavens and the earth.
그래서 사람들은 자꾸 확인을 해보고 싶은 거예요.
So people want to make sure.
근데 말이야 자기야.
But then, honey.
예를 든다면.
Let's take an example.
배를 타고 가다가.
Let's say we're in a boat.
배를 타고 가다가.
And as we're in the boat.
배가 암초에 걸려서 이렇게 파손이 됐는데.
Let's say it got, you know, crushed.
거기에는 두 명만 타는 보트가 있는데.
And then there's only an emergency boat where only two people can get on the small boat.
어머니하고 나하고 물에 빠졌어.
Let's say your mother and I are both inside the water.
2인용 보트인데
And this is only a two-person boat.
누구를 태울 거야?
Who would you save?
이 아내는 자기를 태울 거라고 생각을 했습니다.
So this wife thought, oh, surely he'll pick me.
그냥 거짓말이라도
Even though he lies to me
그래도 사랑하는 당신을 태워야지.
And she hoped to hear, oh, of course, honey, I'll pick you.
이런 대답을 기다렸는데
So the wife expected to receive this answer.
주저 없이 대답을 한 거예요.
But then the husband answered,
어머니를 태워야지.
Of course, I'll take my mother.
남편을 향한 기대감이 다 무너져버렸어요.
So all her hopes and her husband crumbled down.
아, 이 남자가 사랑한다는 말은 거짓말이었구나.
Oh, this man, he says he loves me, but he's a liar.
이 남자를 어떻게 평생 믿고 살까?
How can I believe in this man and live with him for the rest
고민,
of my life?
고민이 마음의 고민이 찾아온 거예요.
So suddenly she had a lot of worries and conflict in her heart.
아, 자기로서는 풀어낼 수가 없었기 때문에.
So she could not resolve this in her heart.
인생 상담소에 문의를 했어요.
And so she had like a gone to a counselor.
사연을 이야기하고.
And she told that person everything that happened.
내 남편이 나를 사랑하는 줄 알았는데.
I thought my husband loved me.
그거는 입에 발린 말이었습니다.
But he was just saying with his words.
이 남자와 평생을 남은 생애를 같이 살아야 될지 고민이 됩니다.
And so I have to decide, am I going to live with this man for the rest of my life?
계속 살아야 될지 헤어져야 될지 상담을 해주십시오.
So please advise me, should I live with this man or just cut it off with him?
얼마 후에 그 상담소에서 편지가 왔습니다.
And so later on from the, you know, council service, they sent her a letter.
어떤 답이 왔을 것 같습니까?
What kind of reply do you think she got?
당신도 수영을 배우세요.
You also must learn to swim.
남편이 안 건져주더라도
Even though your husband doesn't save you,
수영을 배울 수 있는 수영을 해서 나올 수 있는 그 기술을 배우라고 했습니다.
You must learn the skill to save yourself by swimming.
여러분들 오늘 우리가
So everyone today
인생을 믿는 것이 아니고
We should not believe in ourselves.
사람들이 돕지 않아도
Even though people don't help
하나님이 도와주시고
We believe that God will help us.
하나님이 이끌어 주신 믿음을 배운다면
And if we learn the faith that is God who will lead us
여러분의 인생 행복하고
Then your life will truly be happy.
감사한 삶을 살 것입니다.
And you'll live a very thankful life.
그래서 여러분들도
So I hope that you
수영을 배우시듯이
you also like learning to swim?
믿음을 배우시길 바랍니다.
Hope that you can learn faith.
그래서 이 아내가 남편에게 물어봤어요.
So this wife asked the husband.
왜 어머니를 태우려고 해요?
Why did you choose your mother?
어머니는 한 분이기 때문에 돌아가시면 어머니가 없지만.
So if my mother is the only one who gave birth, so if she passes away, there's no other mother for me.
아내는 다시 얻을 수 있으니까.
But the wife, I could get another wife.
여러분 이런 남자를 믿지 말고.
So don't believe in this kind of husband.
변치 않는 하나님을 믿게 되길 바랍니다.
I hope that you can believe in the God who does not change.
그래서 무전전도행은.
So as we went to the no money witnessing trip.
사람에게서 하나님에게로 피하는 삶입니다.
So from avoiding people, we're only depending on God when we go to the witness trips.
그래서 이 사도행전 14장에 보면
So if you look at Acts chapter 14,
헛된 일을 버리고
So throw out the, you know, useless works.
만유와
you know, with the
하늘과 아
몇 장이야?
14장. 30절인가? 제가 okay, 이야기하면 천지와 바다와 하늘을 지으신 하나님.
So God who created the seas and the heavens.
모든 것을 지으신 하나님께로 돌아오라 그랬습니다.
It says come back to God who has formed the heavens and the earth.
그래서 무전전도행은
So the no money witnessing trip.
모든 것을 다 내려놓고
Put down everything.
하나님을 의지하고 나갈 때
And when you only go out believing in God,
하나님이 도우시고 일하시는 것을 경험하는 세계입니다.
That you truly experience God who will help you and be with you.
오늘도 이렇게 미국에서
So today in America,
무전전도행을 다녀온 한 선교사님이 나와서 어떻게 무전전도행에서 도우셨는지 간증을 듣고 또 제가 잠시 이야기하고 마치겠습니다.
So today we'll have a testimony from one of our missionaries in America who actually went on a no money witnessing trip. He'll give his testimony and then I'll wrap up.
미국에서 선교하고 계시는 유지훈 선교사님 나오셔서 간증해 주시겠습니다.
So missionary Yujun from America will come and share his testimony.
헬로 에브리원. 한국말로 할까요? 예. 헬로 에브리원. I'm very happy to hear to share my testimony to you. Actually I can share with very happily right now, but in 2010 when I go to No Money Witnessing trip, it was hardship. Most the biggest hardship in my life. But it turned totally blessing in my life. It had about 2010. Back then, 2010, we have a camp in LA, Los Angeles. In Los Angeles, our Good News Mission pastor had together. At that time, our teacher pastors, Pastor Park, he was chastised us a lot. The reason why he chastised us, because he chastises that we do not live by faith. At the time, he said that you don't have to live by faith because you have your car, because you have your credit card, money, member of your church, house, church. So everything is like everyone can support you, so you don't have to rely on God. That is why you don't live by faith. And then that is the main topic he chastised and he counseled us. And suddenly, Pastor Park, he had great wisdoms. He suddenly suggested another one programs. So this time, we received 10 volunteers for attend no money mission ministering trip for a month, not a week, for a month. And then he said, leave everything behind, your money, credit card, everything behind, just one backpack, go to certain city without any information and without any relative. Just go. And then stay 1 month. And then see, he's help you. See, he help you. And the pastor said, and I read the Bible, God, Bible says he surely help us. But I hope you see, I hope you experience that he help you. And then, next, he said, next. And then he said, if he doesn't help, burn Bible. Burn Bible, don't come back to church anymore. You know, everyone, I didn't have any faith. But once I hear that, quite like, oh, really? Okay. Do you understand what I mean? It was not a faith. Oh, really? Okay. Okay, God, if you don't help me, I will not trust you anymore. I will not trust you anymore. But when I'm thinking, our pastor, he always talking about faith. But he said, if he doesn't help you, burn Bible, don't come back to church. I never heard this message from my pastor. He truly believed that he definitely helped you. And then we come back. I was ministering in Orlando, Florida at the times. I came back to Orlando, Florida. And stay 1 month, lay over 1 month, 1 week. And then for a week, I have a lot of like struggling in my heart. You know, I volunteers, okay, I will go. And after that, and I come back, after meeting, and I come back, come out from the door, I immediately regret. Oh my, it was crazy. Why did I do that? And it was about, I came to United States in 2008. So I came, at the time I came to United States just 2 years. So my English is not really good. And as you know, I'm Asians, and I'm not really like major race, and I don't know anyone. So when I thinking about this, and I thinking about all this situation, this is like totally crazy, crazy things. So my heart, full of regret. It doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense. And then I come back to Orlando, Florida. At the time, most of my members in Orlando, Florida is Korean people. So I didn't have chance to speak English many times. At that day, for a week, I have chance to travel. I have chance to travel to Jacksonville, Florida to prepare the conference. But on the way to highway, my heart is like, keep like praying. Do you know what did I pray? Lord, please cancel this program. Please cancel this program. Doesn't make sense. You understand what I mean? So I pray for cancel these programs on the way. But when I praying, I felt like God speak to me. And I thinking myself, why you so feel burdened? Why I feel so burdened? And I answer myself, of course, God. There's no house, no money, no car, no relative. No one can help me. Of course, feel burdened. But suddenly, I thought different way. Why are you trying to stay in Orlando, Florida? I couldn't say anything. Do you know why, everyone? I thought I was in Orlando, Florida for gospel. I thought I was staying in Orlando for the church, for God, for gospel, for ministry. But when I have thinking this way, and I, like, vice versa, do you understand? Like I feel burdened to go to, I feel burdened to the no money mission trips to feel burdened. The reason why, I don't have money, I don't have a house, I have a car. But God asked me, why you stay in Orlando? Because I have a house, because I have a car, I have money, I have people to help me. Do you understand what I mean? I felt, you're a liar. You thought you stay in Orlando for church. You said you're staying in Orlando for gospel, for God. Not at all. The reason why you stay in Orlando is because there is a house, there is a money, there is a car. I can't say anything. I can't say anything. I can't decide one. Even though I still burdened, but I felt like I have to go. Even I preaching people that you have to live by faith. I don't live by faith. That all my speaking is just knowledge. All my speaking just like mouth. So I felt like I have to go to experience. And then the headquarters, church headquarters called us to Atlanta. And in Atlanta we have a meeting. And then there are three pastors. Yesterday, you may have Pastor Kim. Yesterday, him and me and another couple. Another couple will share testimony tomorrow. Three of us together there. And then church give us, take every my money, my car key, my credit card, everything. And then he church gave us one way. Tom. One way. Greyhound tickets. I did not know the destinations. Once I see the ticket, I know Atlanta to Memphis. Everyone, I did not know anything about Memphis. I thought Memphis was one of the city name of Egypt. I did not know there is a city name is Memphis in United States. But I search about the Memphis. Next. Memphis is one of the high crime city in United States. Do you know that? Detroit? Memphis, St. Louis is most top high crime in the United States. But I didn't know that. So once I get on the bus, I slap. I close my eyes because I didn't want to open my eyes. As I sleeping, I keep saying, this is dream. This is dream. This is dream. Think about it. Even like staying 1 week is hard, but staying 1 month. And then when church gave us a one-way ticket, and pastor said, you have to come back. It was September 7, September 7, 2010. And the church pastor said, you have to come back October 3rd by New York. I asked pastor, where's the return tickets? God will give you. Amazing, right? God will give you. And we just get up to the Memphis. And we just get on the bus. I close my eyes. I didn't pray. I just murmured myself, this is dream. This is dream. I slept. And later, buses stopped. September 7, 2010. And I remember Memphis was a little bit showering the weather. It was like a little rain. And I get off the bus. Once I get off the bus, it was so hard. Where should I go? Where should I go? No one direct me where I have to go. And then where am I? I know this is city of Memphis, but I don't know where am I. So I saw the one hotels, and next I went to the hotels and get the map from the hotels. I look at the map, it made me more frustrating because map does not tell me where I have to go, right? So where should I go? Where should I go? And me and my wife, one backpack, and I saw the map. I saw the one like park in the center. I told my wife, let's go to this park. You don't know about I live in Memphis right now. You don't know about the Memphis, but that park is Overton Park. Is one of the largest park in Memphis, but I was in downtown. Downtown was all the way in west, and park is center. So me and my wife walk from downtown to park about 6 hours walking to park, and I arrived about 6 p.m. and I sit on the bench. I lay on the bench. I slept again because I don't want to think anymore, and my heart frustrating, complain, doesn't make sense. Full my heart of this. But about 8 o'clock, I had to open my eyes because, you know, skip the food is okay because I ate the day before yesterday we depart. But I have to find some place to sleep, right? And then I was staying with my wife. If I stay myself, I can stay outside, but I can't stay with the woman together. So I start next. I start knock the door. I start knock the door and knock the door one by one. And people they didn't open their door. And they're who? Hello, I'm missionary from Korea. I'm missionary from Orlando. I came to mission trip. I want to have a Bible study. You know, I asked for a Bible study, but in my heart, let me sleep. Let me stay your house tonight. Please accept us. But no one accept us until about 10 p.m. I knocked the door many places. It was so, I don't know what should I do. And then I don't know where am I going. I feel like its atmosphere, its street is more bad and bad. Maybe I go to wrong directions, bad and bad. So it's really afraid of me. But I knocked at one house, and the lady said, she said, no, I can't accept you. And I go to next house, and next house. But suddenly somebody called us behind us. And then one lady come with one pajama, and one has a cigarette in her hands, and follow me. And then, you can't do that here. You know, quite like southern accent. You know, you can't do that here. Here is very dangerous. You don't know what street it is? Last week, one pregnancy, she murdered. Because one drug addict, she killed her to take $30. So it's very dangerous street. You can't do that. If you knock the door like this, they'll accept you, and they will kill you, and then they'll rape your wife. That's what she said. Oh, really? And then she said, follow me. And then follow her. And then she started fine. She said, I cannot accept you. I have a 10 cat, 10 dogs in the house. No place to let you in. But she trying to find one house. And she called everywhere. But ultimately, she couldn't find. And then she said, did you eat something? No. The way here. And then she inside the brush one two plate. It was so tasty because he was so hungry. I eat. And then she said, I couldn't find any place, but and I cannot accept you because as I told you, I have my loving 10 cat, 10 dogs. So she said, but I let you stay my porch, the porch. And then it is more safety than street. And then she make us stay in the backyard in the porch, and she gave us a mattress and then sleep in here. You know, me and my wife sit on there and not asleep. I couldn't sleep. A lot of mosquito at the night. I couldn't sleep well. But at the night, I have thinking a lot of things. But I thought two things. One is amazing. Wow, it can happen. Somebody help us. Somebody help us in these situations. And another one is, oh my God, how can I stay like this 1 month? Do you understand, everyone? I didn't have faith at all. I didn't have any faith at all. Always full of complain and worry. And I look at the situations. Always fear. Next day, me and my wife get up from the house about 5 a.m. And I start walk on the, there's a main street named Poplar Avenue. I walk on the Poplar Avenue, alongside Poplar Avenue. And I, you know, we walk many places. We walk many places. But when we walk, I was tired. So I saw the one chair that there. So I sit on the bench. But my wife, she saw the building behind the bench. And she entered the bench. Maybe she looking for some restrooms. And then when she entered the bench, and then when she come out, she went to the building, and when she come out, she come another man together. And then he introduced himself. My name is John. And then I heard about you from your wife. So I'd like to invite you, come in. And then he invited us to that house, but it was not a house. It was certain Christian organization buildings. Name is SOS. And then they ministry about the building, like the old house to fixing for poor people. They do about this kind of ministry. And then he introduced about his ministry, and he asked about his my how do you come to here. And I give my testimony, and I give out not a testimony. I show I don't have any faith, but I came here by pushing by my pastor. And I explain. And then he said, oh, your pastor is great. Okay. And then what do you want to do? And she said, I asked him, I want to take shower. And then he gave us take shower place, and we shower and washing laundry, and then I came out. And then he said, I have to go to some place, so I have to send you out. Okay, thank you. And I came out the building, and I walking about a few minutes, about few miles. Suddenly, some certain cars honking behind us. And then he followed us, and he said, did you lunch? No, we didn't. And then he said, go to this Mexican restaurants. And then he led us into the Mexican restaurants, and he ordered to the food, and he paid the tips, everything. And then he said, I hope you meet again, and I hope you have a successful trips. And we eat a lot at the lunch with that food. And I walk after it. You know, my heart, little by little, changed because search keep happen that I never expecting. You know, in the beginning of the trip, I have over full of fear and full of complain. But little by little, God is working. And we walked to the University of Memphis, and I went to University of Memphis to start witnessing, like trying to talking with people, talking with the Bible study. But it time passed. It's about 7 o'clock again. You know, let me tell you, during the normal mission witnessing trip, food is not really problems. Problems are lodgings. Nighttime is scared. Where should I have to sleep? So we start knock the door again. While I knock the doors, suddenly ring on my phone. As I told you, I was ministering in Orlando, Florida. Orlando area code is 407. So most of call that I receive is a 407 start 407. But the phone that was ringing is start 901. 901 is Memphis area code. So 901. Memphis? I don't know anyone in Memphis. Who is? And I asked on the phone, hello, who is this? They said, hello, is this Pastor Aaron? Yes, I am. My name is Quentin. Okay. I don't know who you are. But he said, I know who you are. How do you know me? He said, I know about you from John. Do you remember John? I know about you, John. And I really want to meet you. Oh, really? Okay. Where are you? And I give them my point. And then the Quentin, he came with his car to the point. And then he picked us up and go to the barbecue restaurants. And in Memphis, most famous thing is Memphis barbecue. Have you heard about it? Memphis barbecue restaurants. And he treat us with the barbecue. I was so happy. My God, Lord, keep eating. He's speaking to me, asking me something, but I can't hear anything. I can keep eating. I keep eating. And then after I eating, I fall. And he asked me, how can you come these trips? He asked me many things. And then by the chance, and I explained about my salvation testimony. And then I became righteous. I said, I became righteous. But he asked me, how can you be righteous? And I asked him, do you want to know? Yes, I want. I said, let's go to your home. And he said, okay, let's go. I said, me and my wife go to his home. And I preaching gospel to him until midnight. He accepted the gospel. I was so happy. I expecting he let us stay in the home. But after he finished about midnight, he said, but I cannot let you stay in my home because this is not my home. I stay with my friends, but you have your wife. That's why you can't stay in my home. But he said, but I asked my boss. My boss, he went to mission trip, not mission trip. He went to business trip. So his home is empty. I asked my boss that let you stay in his home. He said, okay. So he take us to that house, I'll show you. Tom. This is Quentin. that I met last, at the times, and this is his boast house. And he gave us, he allowed us to stay in his boast house, and then his boast master bedroom. You know what? The master bedroom better than my master bedroom. It's a huge restrooms and the washer machines. I was so happy. I preaching gospel fellowship every day with him, and every morning times he take us to go to the school. He is a college school students, and then he drop us to school and go to class, and after class he called us and pick us up. He buy us a subway and bring back to home, and then we fellowship again. Amazing thing, God allows to staying about a few days here. Everyone, I didn't have any faith, but I saw God help us every day. You know, if I tell you all this story, maybe a few hours. You know, after that, another man, he called us again. He hospitality us in his house a few days. And then later then, my heart, I have to decide, I want to experience more of the place. So I went to different place, but like God keeps sent us people who help us. In the middle of the trip, let me tell you one of the story. Middle of the trip, I want to experience. I had the place I can stay, but I have a different heart. I want to experience how he helped us again. That's why I told him, I will depart from your home today. I will not stay. I will not come back again because I want to experience. And I come back. I come out. And I walk the street. And I walk the street. At that day, we went quite wrong way. Because no house. Do you understand? Two sides, no house. About few hours I walked to no house. Keep like mountain and like field and walking. I feel like we came wrong way. In order to receive grace, at least we meet somebody, right? But it's only thing I can see is fields. And I walk. But suddenly one car just stopped. I can remember it was Toyota Prius. The one just stopped. And then he say, "Get on the car." And then I saw one white man. So, okay. And I entered the car. And then he said, "Where are you going?" So, where are my destinations? Then, where am I heading to? I just go to that place. I'm just heading this way. Okay, where are you going? I'm a missionary. And I'm speaking about me. And he said, "This morning, when I go to work this way, I saw you, one man and woman, get the one backpack walking, because this day not many people walking on the street, so walking. And I finish the work, when I come back, you are still walking. So I'm curious who you are." So he turned away to come back, and then he take us to the Korean restaurants. There's only one Korean restaurant in Memphis. Now I ate, of course, God feed me every day, but he didn't feed Korean food, but he guided us to the Korean restaurants, and then he told me that order what you want to eat. So I order many things, and I eat, and then he said, "Wait here." We went out, he come back, and then give me the $200. Then do not stay outside, go to hotels. And then he gave me the testimony. He's not a Mormon right now, but he was Mormon. And then he went to missionary to Sweden as a Mormon missionaries. At the time, many people helped us when he was young. When I saw you, it reminded me at the times. So I felt that I need to help you. So he gave us $200 and asking his numbers, his name, but he said, "I don't want to tell you my name and my number. God say, do not know other people your good things," right? And he just write his name and he went. I have this kind of happening. And another happening is me and my wife walking. always start walking, walking to the one place. But the one place, it was like, you know what? Memphis is a dangerous city. It's every week, 2-3 times has a gunshot in Memphis. But me and my wife walking to the street, but I did not know where is good, where is bad. But I feel like walking to like ghetto area, crime area. Now I know this most crime area right now. But I walking there, but I can feel house is like more bad and closed. There's an wood block by window, and the people on the street are their eyes are not pointed, really not good. And then it was 9 o'clock, 9 p.m. So I felt like very afraid. I fear. Oh, where should I go? Where should I go? I feel like I have to enter somewhere. So I asked somebody. I saw the one lady stand there. So I asked, can I stay? Then she said, okay, enter, come in. When I entered there, but I regret, it's more dangerous. Once I enter, it's like, it smells, drug smells in there. And then kids are eating something, strange things. And then no window in the house. And a lot of cockroach. No furniture at all. And then the lady, I can saw under lights, her lady's eyes not, point is not good. She is, I can see she's drug addict. So I feel like we shouldn't be here. And we come out again. We come out, we're walking. I don't know where should I go. But I saw the one church. And the church meeting, like they just finished the meeting. And the members come out from the church with the car. And I start knock the window of car, and then, hey, help me. Could you drop us to more safety place? But no one opened door. No one opened doors. But I knocked the windows, like, because cars are waiting for signal. In the windows. But he said, but suddenly, behind there, one man called me. Who are you? And I say, he's a pastor of the church. And then I explain him, he said, get out of my car. And then he guided us to one restaurants. And then it was noodle restaurants, and make us eat the noodle. And then he said, wait here. He went out and come back. He gave us $220 and give us money. You know, but at that day, I still remember, that day is in Korean, dates are Chuseok. It was, Korean Thanksgiving Day. So me and my wife talking, oh, today is Korean Thanksgiving Day. Why we are hungry? And then we are talking in Korea. If we are Korea, then we eat this one, we eat this one. But that night, we eat that food. And God allowed us, like, that food. And then we stay in the hotel. Everyone, I can tell you every stories I have. Like, I met another man who stay us the Radu Fuin, and I stay in the house. Anyway, we were staying for 30 days. God never let us stay in outside even one night. I never stay in outside one night. God always get us to stay in inside. And then, you know what? Me and my wife, at the end of the trip, me and my wife hesitated. Do we have to go back to New York by bus or plane? Which means God allowed us funds as well. Everyone, in my heart, I didn't have any faith. Throughout the trip, God teach us faith one by one. God show us, I'm here. I'm looking at you. I'm helping you. Everyone, one of the thing I learned through this trip, through the trips, God taught me something. Every time I stand before intersections, it was so strange, it was so frustrating. Everyone, this is not my struggling in mission trip, in my struggling of my life. That is, Where should I go? Turn right? Turn left? Go straight? Next. 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 Yeah, every time I went to the intersections, it was frustrating to me. Turn left, turn right, go straight. You know why? If God prepared His grace in the right side, but I decided the left side, whose fault? Right? God prepared His grace the left side, but I decided that I turn right side. I have this kind of thought. That's why, how do I know where you prepared your grace? So that is why I couldn't decide. Everyone, this is not my like mission trip, ministry trip struggling. It was my struggle in my life. That is why every time I stand before intersections, it was frustrating me. But everyone, throughout the trip, God taught me something. Turn right, turn left, to go straight, next. Next time. Go straight. Wherever I go, next. Next. He's there. My decision is not important. My choice is not important. Even though I made a wrong choice, even made a wrong decisions, God is there. The problem is not a wrong decisions. Problem is without no faith. No faith that God can help me. Even I go to wrong place. Right, everyone? God, throughout this trip, God taught me, wherever I go, He's there. Problem is not wrong decisions. Problem is I did not have faith that wherever I go, He's there. Amen? Thank you for listening to my testimony, and I have the chance to just share testimony. Thank you very much.
네, 감사합니다.
Thank you so much.
할 말이 많지요.
You had a lot to share, right?
끝까지 들었으면 좋겠는데.
We want to hear everything.
저도 이제 마무리 해야 될 시간이 돼가지고.
So we have to wrap it up.
좀 이야기를 하겠습니다.
So I want to share a little bit.
우리는 어떤 선택을 해야 됩니다.
So we need to make a choice.
선택을 하고 나면 집중해야 됩니다.
And after we make a choice, we need to focus.
성공의 비결은
So what is the secret to success?
선택과 집중에 있다고 합니다.
So it depends on how you focus and how you go after it.
하나님은 우리를 복을 주실 때
So when God gives us blessings,
인간에게 있는 어떤 조건을 가지고 복을 주시는 것이 아니고
He never gave us blessings according to our condition.
하나님 마음에 결정을 했습니다.
So God has already decided.
창세기 8장 20절에 보면
If you look at Genesis chapter 8 verse 20,
그 중심에 이르시되 그 중심에 이르시되
So God is saying about our heart.
내가 사람으로 인한 땅을 저주하지 않겠다.
So I will no longer curse the earth.
하나님 마음에 결정을 했습니다.
So God made a decision in his heart.
사람으로 인한 땅을 저주하지 않겠다.
I will no longer give curse on the earth.
다시 말하면 사람으로의 땅을 축복하지도 않겠다는 얘기입니다.
And so God is also saying that He will not also give only blessings.
사람들은 인간의 선택에다 둔 것이 아니고.
So God doesn't leave it up to the man's choice.
하나님에게다 두었습니다.
So it depends on God.
창세기 22장 18절에 보면.
So if you look at chapter 8, verse 20.
천하 만민이 천하에 있는 모든 사람들이.
So all the people in this world.
내 씨로 말미암아 천하 만민이 복을 받을 거라고 얘기했습니다.
And through my seed, the whole earth will receive the blessing.
인간이 구원을 복을 받을 수 있는 조건은
So the condition to receive blessing
예수님으로 하겠다는 겁니다.
Is through Jesus.
그 사람들은 어리석게도 자기의 판단이나 자기의 생각을 따라가는 겁니다.
But many people only believe in their thoughts and their own ideas.
그래서 많은 세상의 사람들이
So a lot of people in this world
자기에게 갇혀 있는 사람을 쓰는 것이 아니라
God doesn't use the people who is trapped in their self.
자기 생각 밖으로 나오는 사람들을 통해서 일을 합니다.
God wants to work through the people who go beyond their thoughts.
세상에 많은 사람들이 실력이나 어떤 지식은 많은 것을 가지고 있습니다.
So people in this world have the many experience, many knowledge.
사람들은 자기 선택 안에서 복을 받으려고 합니다.
So they try to receive the blessing within their own choices that they make.
한국의 큰 대기업에서
In Korea, there's a big companies.
사원을 모집했습니다.
And so they're recruiting.
한국에는 좋은 기업에 들어가려고 공부하는 학생들이 엄청 많습니다.
There's many students who work very hard to get recruited to those big companies.
사람들에게서 지식이나 실력을 찾는 것이 아니라
In this world, they no longer just look for the knowledge and experience.
자기 생각밖에 다른 생각을 이런 생각을 가리켜 창의적이고 창조적인 생각이라고 합니다.
So those companies are looking for people who go outside and beyond their own thoughts and are creative.
자, 시험을 봐가지고 점수를 가지고는 잘 평가가 잘 안 됩니다.
And so we cannot judge people by just giving tests.
그 사람들에게 그 인터뷰를 합니다.
And so they have interviews with the recruits.
그 면접 시험을 통해서.
And through the interviews,
인간의 생각 밖에 나오는 사람들을 찾고 있습니다.
And they're looking for people who are beyond just the regular human thoughts.
그래서 이 1차적으로 한 80명을 뽑아가지고.
And so in the first round, they pick 80 applicants.
사원을 모집하는데 2만 명이 지원을 했습니다.
And so for this job, about 20,000 had applied.
그중에 80명을 뽑았고.
They only picked 80 out of the 20.
그 80명 중에서 이제 최종 합격자를 갈려내는데
And so out of the 80 they must come to the final.
그래서 문제를 냈습니다.
And so they give a question.
여러분이라면 어떻게 하겠습니까?
In this situation what would you do?
여러분들도 문제를 풀어 보세요.
Okay, I'll give you the question. You try to solve this problem.
어떤 대기업에 한국에 있는 큰 대기업에
So this is a really big company in Korea.
지원을 했습니다.
And so they
여러분이라면 어떻게 하겠습니까?
This is a question. What would you do in this situation?
큰 부잣집 아들이
So there is a big rich man's son.
있었습니다.
There was a son.
아버지가 큰 부자였기 때문에
So because his father is very wealthy.
아들도 그 재산을 많이 물려받았어요.
Of course the son would inherit all the possession of the father.
그래서 아주 멋있는 스포츠카를 샀습니다.
And so they bought a very good-looking sports car.
한 20만 불 정도 되는 스포츠카를 샀습니다.
So about $200,000 sports car.
이거는 오픈되는 오픈카예요.
And so this like opens, you know. Convertible.
이 차는 두 명이 타는 차인데.
So this sports car can only carry two people.
두 명이 타는 차인데.
This is a two-person car.
이 두 명이 타는 차를 타고 이제 한 사람이 이 운전사 운전을 하고 가고 있었습니다.
And so one person has to drive.
장대 같은 비가 내렸어요.
And now it's coming down with the rain.
그래서 뚜껑을 이렇게 닫았습니다.
And they cover the convertible.
너무 비가 많이 와가지고.
But the rain poured down so hard.
윈도우 브러쉬로 이렇게 닦아도.
And they're trying to get wipe the windshield.
잘 앞이 보이지 않는 거예요.
They could not see the front.
근데 멀리 보니까.
But far in the distance.
버스 정류장에서 세 명의 사람이 기다리고 있는 거예요.
And at the bus stop, there are three people.
차를 기다리고 있는 거예요.
And they're waiting for the bus.
앞에 있는 사람을 보니까.
So we see the people in the front.
의사의 그 진료 가방을 들은 한 의사가 있었습니다.
Because see, one person is a doctor.
비에 젖었지요.
And he's getting wet in the rain.
자세히 보니까.
And we look closer.
이 사람이 큰 병에 걸렸을 때.
And this person who has an illness.
죽을 수 없는 상황에서 병을 고쳐서 살게 한 사람입니다.
So this person is a doctor who fixed his disease.
생명의 은인이었지요.
So he is the one who saved his life.
뒤에 보니까
And in the back of him,
한 할머니가 서 계시는데
grandma standing.
비에 젖어가지고
She was all wet with the rain.
체온이 많이 떨어진 거예요.
And now her temperature has gone down.
병원으로 옮기지 않으면 죽을 수밖에 없는 상황에 있었습니다.
And so she's in a situation. If she doesn't go to a hospital soon, she might die.
근데 세 번째 보니까
And that the third person waiting at the bus stop.
아주 멋진 미인이 서 있는데
There's a very lovely lady.
이건 이상형의 아가씨, 평상시에 만나 결혼하고 싶은 대상이었습니다.
So this lady is a one who's so beautiful as a person that he probably want to marry.
비에 젖어가지고.
And she's getting all wet in the rain.
머리도 뒤에 붙어 있고 너무 멋있는 거예요.
And so she's wearing very nice clothes. Her hair is very nice.
여러분이라면.
So if you were in this situation.
이 한 자리를 어떻게 처리하겠습니까?
So you have one more seat next to you in the car. So how which one would you choose?
누구를 태우겠습니까?
Which one would you give a ride to?
이것이 문제였습니다.
This was the problem that they asked.
사람들은 한 자리를 두고 갈등하고 있는 겁니다.
So one person they're thinking who should I give a ride to?
누구를 태울까?
Who should I give a ride to?
자, 여러분들에게 시간이 없어서 많이 대화를 못 하겠습니다.
So I don't have much time, so I can't give you much time.
5분이 남았는데.
There's only five more minutes.
사람들은 생명의 의사를 생명의 은인은 의사를 태워야지.
So some people may say, "Oh, you should let the doctor who saved your life to sit in your car."
그러면 진짜 인생에 한 번 만날 기회를 잊어버리는 것 같아요.
And then you'll just lose that chance.
할머니를 태우지 않는다면
If you do not give the grandma the ride,
주간은 할머니를 태우지 않는다면,
if you don't give the grandma this ride,
사람들로부터 비난을 받겠지요.
Then you probably get persecuted people around you.
여자를 선택하지 않으면
And if you don't choose a lovely lady,
후회하겠지요.
Then you'll regret.
사람들은 막 거기서 셋 중에서 갈등하고 있습니다.
So people are trying to decide which of the three should I give a ride to.
여러분이라면 한 명 타는 이 자리를 어떻게 하겠습니까?
So if you were in this situation, which person would you pick?
답은 하지 말고 여러분들 마음에 생각하고 맞는지 틀리는지 확인해 보십시오.
Okay, just answer in your heart, so don't say out loud. We'll just
평범한 사람들은 그 세 가지에서 선택을 하려고 합니다.
So the normal people they try to only pick one from the three.
근데 답을 낸 사람들이 몇 명 있었습니다.
But there's a person who gave this kind of answer.
나라면
If I was that person,
이렇게 하겠습니다.
This is how I would do it.
차를 그 세 명 앞에 세우고
I would stop the car in front of the three people.
키를 뽑아가지고
I would take out the key.
운전사에게 주고 아 의사에게 주고.
I would give the key to the doctor.
운전대 앉히고.
Give him the seat in the driver's seat.
아 주워가는 할머니를 태워서.
And give the grandma the ride.
병원으로 옮기고.
And they would go to the hospital.
나는 그 여자와.
And then with that lady.
데이트를 하겠습니다.
I'll have a date with the lady.
사람들은 자기 생각에서 고민하는데
So people only think within their own little limits.
내 생각에서 나와야만 되는 겁니다.
So in your thoughts you think I cannot come out from the car.
오늘 우리는 우리 생각 안에서
Same thing in our thoughts.
어떤 문제를 해결해 보려고 하는데
We try to solve the problem before us.
나를 버리고
But if we throw out us
하나님에게로 말씀 앞에로 나온다면
And we go out in front of God who gave us the word
정말 모든 사람들을 행복하게 하고
Then God will make everyone happy
아, 복된 결과를 얻게 되는 겁니다
And you'll have a very blessed result
그래서 우리는 생각을 버리고
So we must throw out our thoughts
말씀 앞으로 나와야 되는 겁니다
And we must go out in front of the word of God
그래서 오늘 우리의 삶 속에서
So also in our lives
이제 나를 끝내고
So we must end ourselves.
말씀 앞에 나와야 되는 겁니다.
And we must go in front of the word of God.
저도 무전제대를 자주 다녔는데.
I also went to many no money witnessing trips.
자주 느껴지는 것은 어디서 먹고 어떻게 마실 어떻게 잘까?
So a lot of times I fear where I'm going to sleep, what I'm going to eat.
해가 지면서 오는 염려와 걱정이 있습니다.
So as the sun sets, then these worries come down upon me.
근데 모든 것은 하나님에게 있는데
But everything is in the hands of God.
하나님에게로 마음이 잘 옮겨지지 않을 때가 있는 거예요.
But sometimes our heart is not over to moved over to the
그래서 나에게서
So myself
하나님에게로 옮겨지면
When you're moved over to God
하나님 모든 것을 다 준비해 놓으셨습니다.
And God has prepared everything
자,
for you.
우리가 한 번에 변화가 와야 되는데
So we must receive change.
우리는 이런 이야기를 합니다.
So we say
자 마태복음 6장에 나와 있는 말씀.
If you look at Matthew chapter 6,
이 성경을 보면
If you look at this verse in the
모든
Bible,
모든 것을 다 아신다 했는데.
God says he knows everything about us.
이 하나님의 말씀 모든 것을 다 아시고
God who knows everything.
우리가 이제 모든 걸 아시는데.
He knows that you need everything.
우리는 말씀 앞으로 가는 게 아니고
Instead of going in front of the word of God.
여러 생각 속에 마음에서 두려움 속에 걱정 속에 염려 속에 빠져 있는 겁니다.
We're only stuck in our thoughts, in our worries, and in our situation.
우리 마음이 하나님께로 가서 하나님을 선택하면,
If we choose God and go in front of God,
하나님의 말씀대로 모든 것을 다 채워 주시고,
According to the word of God, God says, I'll give you everything that you need.
아 지켜 주시는 거예요.
And God, He will protect you.
아 저도 지난번에 얘기했던 것처럼. 아 대학생이 우리를 초청해서.
So last time I shared, like a university student invited me.
그들이 식사를 대접하고.
And they bought me meal.
또 우리에게서 말씀을 듣고.
And they listened to the words.
아 돌아오는데.
And we came back.
우리 주머니에 돈을 넣어준 거예요.
And the student also gave us some money.
하나님이 필요한 모든 것을 주셨습니다.
So God gave us everything.
아 일꾼이 그 먹을 것을 하나님은 주신다 그랬습니다.
And God says that He will give the laborer his charges.
그 오늘 우리의 목적이 복음을 전하라고 하는 하나님의 목적 앞에.
So in front of God, who has the focus of preaching the gospel,
그 일꾼이 저 먹을 것을 얻어야 할 거라고 성경은 이야기합니다.
And in the Bible says to give the laborer his wages.
하나 우리가 하나님이 원하시는 일. 또 하나님의 일을 할 때
The work of God that God wants, the work that we do for God
필요한 모든 것을 다 채워 주십니다.
God is saying I will fulfill everything that you need.
그래서 저는 그 도시에서 나와 가지고
So I came out from that city.
청주라는 큰 도시를 갔을 때
And I went to a big city called Cheongju.
13년 만에 대학 동기를 만나게 됩니다.
And in 13 years I met my colleague from college.
길에서 너무너무 반가워하더라고요.
And so I was so like happy to meet up with him.
그 친구는 키가 나보다 컸습니다.
And he's a lot taller than me.
내가 딱 만나면 나하고 딱 이렇게 만났는데
And I met him.
너무 반갑다 하더라고요.
And he was so happy to see me.
그래서 그 친구의 턱이 내 머리에 닿았습니다.
So his chin like goes above my head.
엄청 크지요.
He's very tall.
그래서 안아주면서 이야기합니다.
And then he hugged me and he said,
용만아, 살아줘서 고맙다.
Oh, I'm so glad you're alive.
오늘 우리는 세 명의 친구들이 세 명이 하루 종일 걸었습니다.
So three of us we walked all day.
걷고 점심도 못 먹었는데.
We walked and walked. We couldn't even have lunch.
친구가 이야기하더라고요.
So my friend said.
13년 만에 만난 친구가.
So since I met you in 13 years.
너 뭐 하냐 그러더라.
What do you do?
나 목사한다.
I'm a pastor.
지금 뭐 하냐?
What are you doing now?
무전전도에 간다.
I came on the no money witnessing trip.
그때 형제들 두 명이.
And so the two brothers and I.
어딘가에 가서 전도하고 있었는데.
And we're witnessing.
그들도 형편 앞에서 머물러 있었던 마음을 하나님께로 옮겼습니다.
And so those people were stuck in this situation, but they moved their heart over to God.
누군가 이렇게 열심히 복음을 전하고
And they are preaching the gospel to
someone.
돌아오는
길에
And as they return,
우리를 만납니다.
And they met up with us.
저 사람들은 누구야?
Who are these people?
같이 훈련하고 있는 학생들이다.
They are the students who are being trained.
저녁은 먹었나?
Did you eat dinner?
아직 안 먹었.
No.
식사하러 가자.
Let's go eat.
아주 좋은 레스토랑에 가서
So they took us to a very nice restaurant.
배가 터지도록 먹었어요.
And so I ate until my stomach was about to burst.
그래서 이 저녁에는 밥을 먹고 나서 어디로 가냐?
So after we eat, where do we go now?
아직 행선지는 정해지지 않았지만
So
어디 가야 될 곳 정해지지 않았지만
We don't know where we're gonna go.
네가 우리를 내려주고 싶은 곳에 차를 좀 우리를 내려주면 좋겠다 그랬어요.
So wherever you're going, just drop us off on the way, and we'll just go from there.
다른 도시 진천이라는 도시로 가려고 하는데.
And so they're going to 진천.
차를 타고 가는 동안에 두 친구가 차 안에서 둘이 머리를 이렇게 크로스를 시켜놓고 자고 있는 거예요.
So my two friends in the back, they're like sleeping together with their heads together.
어디 잘 때는 있나?
Do you have any place to sleep?
아직 잘 땐 정해지지 않았다.
We don't know where we're going to sleep.
그 친구는 아주 좋은 호텔로 데리고 와서
So that friend took us to a nice hotel.
체크인을 해 줬습니다.
And checked in for us.
여기서 자라고.
Sleep here tonight.
자기는 집으로 이렇게 갔습니다.
And he must go back home.
너무 고마웠어요.
I was so thankful.
네가 하는 짓을 보면은 너무 무모한 짓을 하는 것 같은데.
What you're doing right now, I feel you're doing crazy things.
너를 위해서는 안 되지만 안아주고 싶어도 저 친구들이 너무 불쌍해서.
So I don't want to help you, but because of your other two friends, I feel sorry for them.
호텔을 잡아줬다 하더라.
So I gave you a hotel.
우리는 길이 없지만 선택을 하나님을 선택하고.
So we have no way, but if we choose God.
말씀이 원하는 길을 따라갈 때 하나님 채워주시는 걸 보았습니다.
And when we follow the word of God, we believe God is the one who fulfills all things for us.
나한테 필요한 여비도 주고.
God gave us all the money we need for transportation.
헤어졌습니다.
And we
헤어졌습니다.
And we parted ways.
그 친구는 딸이 둘이 있었는데.
And that person has two daughters.
다시 내가 집으로 가서 두 아이의 옷을 사가지고. 옷편으로 붙여줬습니다.
So I went back home after the witnessing trip, and I sent my friend two sets of clothes for his daughters.
하나님은 루스를 우연히 보아스의 밭으로 인도하시는 것처럼.
So as God led Ruth into the field of Boaz,
우리를 그렇게 친구를 만나게 하고.
And God allowed me to meet my friend.
또 마음을 나누게 하고.
Allowed me to share my heart.
지금도 사귀고 있습니다.
And even now, I'm still keeping in touch with him.
지금 청주 시청에서 근무를 하고 있습니다.
And he is working in the city hall of Cheongju.
우리의 형편 다 아시는 주님.
God, he knows everything about us.
늘 돌봐 주실 줄을 확실히 아네.
And I know for sure he'll always take care of us.
우리를 도우시는 하나님이 우리와 함께 하고 있습니다.
The Lord who is protecting us is with us.
여러분들도 한번 떠나 보세요.
I hope that you could also try go out somewhere.
하나님이 도우실 것을 믿고.
Go out believing that God's gonna help you.
예, 간증을 하신 분들이 간증하는 시간 되죠. 짧아가지고.
So this is time that we have to share testimony is too short.
다 못하는 것처럼.
So like we cannot say everything.
저도 할 얘기가 많은데.
And I also have many things to share.
여기서 마쳐야 되겠습니다.
We'll just end here today.
내일 또 만나겠습니다.
So I hope to see you again tomorrow.
네, 감사합니다.
Thank you so much.
좋은 하루 되세요.
I hope you have a good day.